It's hard to find a whole lot of positives in a 2-11 season, but thankfully for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, they've had a few of them, including defensive end Jacquies Smith. He went from being an undrafted free agent out of Mizzou to being a cast-off in Buffalo and finding an opportunity in Tampa Bay, eventually earning his way into a starting role. And up until this point in the season, his 6 sacks are second only to Gerald McCoy, including 2 this past weekend in Detroit. So if things keep going this way, he should definitely be part of this organization's future plans. Yeah, so one of the bright spots yesterday, you found a way to get to the quarterback twice, actually. That had to feel good, even though despite the loss.
Yeah, I mean, it's always good, you know, when you can get pressure on these quarterbacks, you know, just turn into a passing league. And, you know, one of the things that negates that if you get pressure on the quarterback. So, I mean, it was good personally to get those sacks, but ultimately you wanted to turn into W's.
Well, and, you know, the team especially relied on you because, you know, all of a sudden you started losing guys there. Clinton wasn't able to play, and then all of a sudden Gerald went down for a brief period of time. And so suddenly, you know, it's relying a lot on you on the outside to bring some of that heat.
Yeah, I mean, it's not only me, you know. We have a unit, you know. And, I mean, even on my sacks, you know, that's a good thing of rushing coverage working together. You know, the guys in the back end made them hold it up long enough for me to, you know, even be able to get around the edge and come get them. But, you know, it's all, we all have to work together in order for those things to work.
And you knew, of course, coming in facing a team like Detroit, that's one of the first things you think about when you think about that team, aside from Calvin Johnson, is that pass rush. You ever kind of feel like, hey, you know what, we need to kind of assert ourselves in this situation and show that we've got a pretty decent pass rush, too?
I mean, yeah, of course. You mean, you look across the league and, you know, that's the big thing about playing on Sundays. It's always competition, you know. We see their D-line and we hear about how the best they are and stuff. You want to go out there and prove, you know, exactly what you can go out there and do yourself, you know. And that's one of the things that we had up on our shoulders.
It still blows my mind, and I think I probably ask you this just about every other week, is how you were overlooked and you went undrafted. Do you kind of feel like every single week, you know, you're going out there and you know, every opportunity you get, you feel like you need to remind every team that you play, hey, I'm the guy you passed on?
Yeah, you have it in the back of your mind. It's just nothing but added motivation, you know. And, you know, I'm a very self-motivated person. So, I mean, any extra incentive you can get, why not use it, you know. But I'm not really even looking forward to that. That was, what, two, three years ago. I'm just looking on who I'm playing against and what I need to do in order to go and prepare and try to play the best game that I can.
What kind of improvements have you made to be able to allow you to have such sudden success, you know, since you've been getting these opportunities here?
I think mostly, like I've said, is basically just being comfortable in the system, you know, getting around this building, being around here long enough to get comfortable. And, you know, coaches putting me in a position, you know, to go out there and basically just let me do my thing, you know. And I mean, that's basically the thing that I can say, just being more comfortable and coaches putting me in a position to just go out there and make plays. And it's up to me just go out there and do it.
Do you just feel like maybe things are really just clicking with you and Coach Cullen and Coach Fair and maybe just the types of things that they're communicating just, you know, you really just happen to get?
I mean, yeah. I mean, just, you know, speaking the same language, you know, that they're speaking, you know, we're all in cohesiveness. And just not even with those guys, even the guys I'm working next with, Gerald, Clint, and Michael and all those guys, you know, I feel like it's more of a cohesion knowing who's next to you every single down, you know. I think that helps out a lot.
What kind of things did you learn from some of those guys up there in Buffalo? Because, I mean, they have quite the pass rush, too.
Yeah, I mean, those guys were great, you know. They helped me out a lot. It's a lot of veteran guys up there, you know, from Jerry to Mario to Kyle and Marcel and even Jarius Wynn and Manny Lawson. Those guys up there helped me out a lot, you know, just taking tidbits from each of those people in their games and just picking their brains, you know, ultimately helped me out to get to where I am right now.
How come it's clicking for you right now? I mean, I'm still trying to figure that out. Just overall, just being comfortable. Is this similar to the scheme that you guys ran at Mizzou?
It is. It is very
similar. You've got some pass rushers that are coming out of that school right now, too. We're starting to see more and more of them.
It is. I mean, you got to give all the credit to, you know, Coach Cool and those guys, finding the guys that he likes and molding them into what he wants them to be. I mean, Coach Steck and those guys, they do a great job up there. And yeah, I mean, just got to tip your hat to them.
Smith is one of a couple guys that's emerged during this very difficult season, finding his way into a starting role. We also saw linebacker Danny Lansana doing the same. And this past weekend, Lansana actually started his third linebacker position. So as of the season's end, he'll have started all three linebacker positions. I can't even tell you how difficult it is to do that. We also are seeing more and more of Bradley McDougal as well at the safety position. So keep an eye out for those guys. We should be seeing more and more of them as the season unwinds, and that should give you a better idea of just how much of a part they'll be of this organization's future plans. Reporting from One Buc Place, with Sports Talk Florida, I'm Jenna Lane.